Hi dears, welcome back to Mathematics Online class. You already studied the multiplication tables. I'm very happy that you all know the multiplication table very thoroughly. Very good, congratulations, keep it up, okay. So because it is very much important in our daily life, okay. The multiplication table is very much important in daily life. How it is important? How the, when we are using these multiplication tables in our day-to-day life, okay, that we will know when we are discussing the next topic, that is word problems. Okay, so word problems, actually the word problems are the life situations, okay. So some situations that happen in our life. So we are going through that situations, okay. So we need to know the multiplication table for solve some situations. Clear? So we already studied the word problems in the addition and subtraction chapter. So I think you all know how to write the steps and all. The same way you can write the steps of this multiplication word problem also. But you have to do only multiplication. Okay. Then how you will find out whether a word problem is multiplication or addition or subtraction? How will you find out? Yes. There is a small method. Small shortcut method is that. Okay. This is only a technique only, okay. So if the word each and such in a question, if there is the words each and such in a question, okay, you can't show that it became a multiplication word problem. Okay, if there is the words each and such in a question, you can show that that is a multiplication word problem. Okay, for example, I'll say one example. Okay, there are 5 pencils. There are 5 pencils in one box. There are 5 pencils in one box. Okay, if there are 8 such boxes. Okay, there are five pencils in one box. If there are 8 such boxes, how many pencils will be there? Okay, there are 5 pencils in one box. If there are 8 such boxes, okay, such means at the ball at there. So there are 5 pencils in each box. You can write here each, only one, anything, okay, no problem. So if there are five pencils in each box, if there are 8 such boxes, how many pencils will be there in all together? The question is clear. There are 5 pencils in each box, okay, in each box there are. Each, how many boxes are there? 8 boxes. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So, 8 boxes. Each box carry how many pencils? 5 pencils. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, so we need to find out the number of pencils all together, okay. How will you find out? You can add 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. But I already told you, no? Repeated addition means, we can do the multiplication instead of the repeated addition, okay. So, how can we find out the answer? How can we find out the answer? Word problem, we need to write the steps also. How will you write the first step? Number of pencils in each box, isn't it? Number of pencils in each box. How much? 5. Next step. Number of such boxes. We already know how to write the steps. Number of boxes. How much is 8? Then what we need to find out? We need to find out the number of pencils. Thus, number of pencils, all together, no, we can write anything, okay, I mean all the box, you can write. So how do you do 5 × 8, okay? That is 5 pencils in 8 box, okay? So 5 × 8, 5 × 8, 40, 5 × 8, 40. So how many pencils are all together? 40 pencils. Is it clear? Okay, so only the thing is that the one is given, you need to find out the many things, that is multiplication. Okay, I'll say once again, one more example. Okay, there are two flowers in each plant. If there are 12 such plants, you need to find out the total number of flowers. Is it clear? There are 2 flowers in all the plants. There are how many flowers are there in each plant? 2 flowers. Okay, only 2 flowers. Every plant has 2 flowers. How many plants are there? 12 such plants are there. Then you need to find out the number of flowers. How will you find out? Very easy. That is number of flowers in each plant, that is 2. Number of such plants, that is 12. So how will you find out the number of flowers in total? 12 × 2. 2 × 2 = 4. 1 × 2 = 2. So how many flowers are there in total? 24 flowers are there. You understood? So you will get each of such in the question, that is to sure that is multiplication. And otherwise you can also think that if the one is given, you need to find out the many things, that when that time you need to do the multiplication. Okay, clear? Okay, then look at the textbook. Take the page number 146. Page number 146. Look at the second question. Okay, first question is there, that we can do it in the live session. Look at the second question. In a garden, there were 32 rows of trees. Row. Okay, how you are sitting in the class in rows ways, no? That is row. In a garden, there were 32 rows of trees. Each row had 25 trees. Each row had 25 trees. Okay, there are 32 rows are there. Then each row had 25 trees. How many trees were there in the garden? So you need to find out the number of trees in the garden. So how will you? Okay, that's a page number 146. Okay. How will you find out this? How will you write the steps? First number is 32, so instead of the number, you can write a number of rows of trees. Number of rows of trees. How much? 32. Okay, next step. Each row had 25 trees. So you need to look at the number. 25 is there. So you can write number of trees in each row. Number of trees in each row. 25. Then what you want to find out? How many trees were there in the garden? You need to find out the number of trees. So thus, number of trees. Okay, so you already got the number of rows and you already got the number of trees in each row. Then how will you find out again? You already got the number of rows. This is the rows. And this is the plants. Okay, 25 plants are there in the each row. How many rows are there? 32 rows. So you need to find out the number of trees. So by multiplying 32 and 25, you get the answer. How will you multiply this in all of you? 32 × 25. First you need to multiply 32 with this 5. 32 × 5. 5 × 2 = 10. Very good. 1 carry over. 3 × 5 = 15. Tell me. Yes, 15 plus this carry over 1. Yes, very good, 16. So the first step is over. Then you need to find out the 32 × 2. 2 × 2 = 4. Where we need to write that 4? This is we are multiplying with the 10th place number. So the answer also we want to start from the 10th place. 2 × 2 = 4. 3 × 2 = 6. Then you need to add these numbers. 0, 6 plus 4, 10, 1 carry over, 6 plus 1, 7 plus 1, 8. So the answer is 800. Answer is 800 trees. Okay, 32 into 25. Okay, 32 into 25. 5 2s are 10, 1 carry over, 3 5s are 15 plus 1, 16. 2 2s are, it is in the tens place, so you need to write the answer also in the tens place. Okay, this is the ones place, this is the tens place. 2 2s are 4. Tens place. Okay, 2 2s are 4, 3 2s are 6. Then add 6 plus 4, 10, 1 carry over, 1 plus 6 is 7, 7 plus 1, 8. So the answer is 800. So the answer is 800 trees. Clear? Yes, very good. Okay, so you need to write down this question and answer in your notebook. Okay, while you are watching this video, you need to take your textbook and notebook and open the textbook, write the question, read the question very carefully and write the question in your notebook and write the answer also. Okay. Okay, then look at the third question. Okay, look at the third question. Each child has three pencils. Each child has three pencils. So how can you write the first step? Number of pencils. Number of pencils. Each child. Okay. Number of pencils in each child. In each child. How much is? 3. Okay, number of pencils in each child, that is 3. And if there are 225 children, so it is the number of children, isn't it? So number of children, that is 225. Okay, so this is the number of pencils each child has. Okay, this is the number of pencils. Each child has 3 pencils. Okay, all the students have 3 pencils. Okay, how many children are there? There are 225 children were there. Okay, so you need to find out the number of pencils there are in all together. Okay, we need to find out the number of pencils. Number of pencils. How will you find out? 225 children have 3 pencils each. You need to find out this answer. Okay, 225 into 3. 5 threes are 15. 1 carry over. 2 3s are 6 plus 1, 7. 2 3s are 6. So how many pencils are there all together? 675 pencils are there. You got it? So whenever 1 is given, you need to find out the many things here. There are 3 pencils with the 1 child. Okay. 1 child has 3 pencils. If we are giving 3 pencils to all the 225 students, how many pencils we need to buy? 670. Is it clear? Got it. Suppose there are in third A or B or C, in each class you have 40 students are there. Okay, another small example. Suppose there are 40 students in third class. If I want to give 2 toffees each, I need to give 2 toffees each. Then how many toffees I need to buy? There are 40 students, number of students is 40. I need to give 2 toffees to all the students. Then how many toffees I need to purchase? Then how will I find out that one number? That is 40 into 2. 40 is the number of students and 2 toffees each I need to give. So that is, how will you find out the answer? 4 2s are 8 and 1 0. So how many toffees I need to purchase from the shop? 80 toffees I need to purchase from the shop. So have you understood the way of doing the multiplication word problem? So listen the video very carefully, read the question very carefully and do that first, as that is 2 and 3rd question in your notebook. Okay, by watching this video you need to do the 2nd and 3rd question in your notebook and we will do the rest of the questions in our live sessions. So you have to study the table very, very carefully. Thank you and have fun.